Antilla. Those of you who work in nursing and midwifery have had a real tough time these past few years. I know that for many of you, it's felt a bit like being in the trenches, you know, bombarded from all sides by constant politically driven change and a stream of new paperwork and some absolutely horrible publicity and your establishments cut to the bone. And thankfully, some of those are on the rise again in lots of places. And it's been tough, really tough. Some people have left, others are determinedly moving forward, and a few others are resigned to just kind of keeping going and plodding along. So here's the impact that I see on all of this on the teams that I work with. The day-to-day demand takes priority over everything else, so that planning for the future and developing expertise and change driven from inside this team takes a back seat. It's like you're constantly firefighting. So I'll help you step back so you can see kind of, you know, the whole picture and balance your effort more between today and tomorrow. For some of you, the joy and the passion has gone out of it, and that's heartbreaking. Because what happens is you start seeing all the negatives and all the things that aren't working, and that has a big, big impact on teams. Now, I'm not all about being all happy-clappy and putting a rosy glow on it when there isn't one. What I am about is getting you back in touch with some of that passion and changing your perspective a bit so that you don't just look at those negative things, and empowering you to start changing it for some of yourselves. And maybe the team isn't pulling together. It might be that you're one of those teams, you know, where you have your own caseload and you're almost like standalone professionals, and yet at the same time they call you a team and you do have to deliver some consistent care and a consistent message, and that requires a conversation. You have to make time for it. Sometimes it feels like there's a kind of unfair distribution of effort. You know, some people work mega hard and others seem to kind of coast. Standards are a bit blurry and you'd rather moan than tackle them and tackle those tough conversations. So I'll create a safe space for you to talk, and I'll ask the tough questions, and I'll teach you how to ask them yourselves and in ways that are supportive and not undermining, and don't raise all your limiting beliefs as well. Lots of teams are exhausted and they're stretched thin in all the wrong places. Lots of teams have fallen for the idea that being dedicated means giving everything you have and everything you are. I'll help you push self-care up the agenda. And know that it is not selfish. It's compulsory. You cannot care for patients when you can't care for yourselves and for each other. If I'm coming through the door of your department or your ward on a trolley, I want to know that I'm in the hands of people who are safe. And for me, safety is more than just professionally competent. I want to know that you have had something to eat and something to drink, that you go to the loo when you need, that you get a reasonable night's sleep, and you take your holidays without taking your mobile phone onto the beach. And believe me, I know nurses who do that. Overall, I'll help you feel like a team again. So why me? Well, I've worked alongside nurses and midwives for over 10 years. In community settings and hospitals and hospices, and I'm not a nurse. So I can't buy into that, or you know how it is in nursing stuff. I can stand back and I can observe, and I can help you do the same. Because you cannot change anything unless you can stand back and look at it. So book an hour in my diary. Talk to me about how I can support your team so that you can be a part of a team that you're proud of. The link is down there. Book now. See you.